Hello students, today's class is about embryo development. Last class I discussed about fertilization process. You know, after fertilization, when the embryo will form, it will ultimately develop in female body, means within the female reproductive tract. First of all, in fallopian tube, there will be first of all in fertilization. After fertilization, there will be cleavage, means morula will form, and after that it will come into the uterine wall, and therefore it will develop. So the development of the embryo or the zygote, the development after fertilization, the zygote will form, and the development of zygote in the female reproductive system or in the female reproductive tract, that is known as cleavage. That is the topic today. So we will discuss about cleavage. So I have written here, three steps are there. Number one, morula. Number two, blastula. Number three, gastrula. So number one, morula, blastula, and number three, gastrula. So these three steps are there in the formation of embryo in human body. I'm starting here. First of all, morula. You know, in fertilization, one egg, and within the one egg, one nucleus is present, and therefore the sperm nucleus will enter, and therefore it will produce 2N, means zygote will form. And after that, that zygote will again divide, and it will form a cell mass. It will ultimately, in zygote, just only single cell. But after that, when in rapid way the zygote will divide, ultimately there will be cell division, and therefore the zygote will form the structure taking 16 to 17 cells approx. That is the structure morula. So after the formation of zygote, the structure which will form into the fallopian tube, that is just a cell mass consisting of 16 to 17 cells. That is the structure that is known as morula. And the morula, again it will come into uterine wall. Ultimately there will be implantation. The implantation will occur in the dorsal side of the uterus, in the dorsal wall of the uterus implantation will occur. The cell mass, means the morula, will come into the dorsal side of the uterus, and therefore there will be the implantation. It will easily implanted here. So that is the stage, that is morula. It will occur containing 16 to 17 cells are there, and that is the cell mass. So it is the first stage in cleavage due to formation of zygote. After the formation of zygote in female body, morula will form. It consisting of 16 cells and ultimately a hollow cell mass it is. After the formation of morula, there will be formation of blastula. And look at the structure of cell mass here. 16 to 17 cells approx are there, but in the structure of blastula there will be approximate 17 to 100 cells are there. So ultimately rapid cell division, again the cell wants to divide, and the cell repeatedly it will divide, and it will form the structure that is blastula taking 70 to 100 cells. But in case of morula, there are no layers in the cell mass, no layers are there. But in case of blastula, there will be formation of one layer. So one layer hollow sphere, that is the structure that is blastula. After morula, there will be formation of blastula taking 70 to 100 cells are there, and one layer, one hollow sphere, that is the structure that is known as blastula. So second stage of cleavage, it will occur, that is blastula. And when it will ultimately occur, it will occur means, you know, when morula will form, ultimately morula from fallopian tube, it will come into the uterus, and after all in the dorsal wall of the uterus it will be implanted. So the growth and the development or formation of cells, that the blastula will form ultimately in the uterine wall after implantation. Next stage is very important. Next is gastrula. This is the third stage or the final stage of cleavage, means in the development of embryo, especially in human embryo, gastrula is very very important, because after formation of blastula, gastrula will form, and in gastrula it is also cell mass taking more cells. In blastula 70 to 100 cells are there, but in case of gastrula there are more cells, and there will be formation of three main layer: ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. If I say from inner side to outer, so in gastrula there will be formation of three main layer. One is ectoderm, second is mesoderm, and the third one is endoderm. So ultimately, if I go from outside towards the inner, so ectoderm in the middle, mesoderm, and the inner side endoderm. And these three layers are very very important, and their functions are very very important. If I say ectoderm, in the ectoderm there will be formation of skin, nervous system, eyes, ears. Similarly, in the mesoderm there will be formation of notochord, heart, muscle, kidney. And in endoderm there will be formation of elementary system or elementary canal, and respiratory system, excretory system. So respiratory system, excretory system, elementary system means the digestive system also, it will also form in the endoderm. So among any other stage of cleavage, gastrula is very very important. You will just read 2 to 3 characters from morula, from blastula and gastrula, and in gastrula these three stages are very very important. Number 1 ectoderm, number 2 mesoderm, and number 3 endoderm. So ectoderm responsible for skin, nervous system, eyes, ear. Mesoderm responsible for the formation of notochord, heart, muscle, kidney. And endoderm responsible for the formation of elementary system, respiratory system, and excretory system. So starting from morula to gastrula, ultimately the development of embryo occurs. So the development of embryo occurs from morula to gastrula. Single cell, zygote. Cell mass without layer, morula. Cell mass with taking one sphere layer, means the one sphere cell mass. So one layer sphere cell mass, that is next, that is the structure blastula, and after blastula that is gastrula. Gastrula is very very important because there are three main layer: ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. And in blastula there is also one layer, and within the blastula, blastocyst are there. It ultimately it will form, it will ultimately develop. So these three are the main stage of the development of embryo. Next is what is embryo and what is fetus? So is there any kinds of difference? Yeah, actually from the time of pregnancy, you know, if I say about 8 weeks means 2 months, so up to 8 weeks, 0 to up to 8 weeks, the time period of pregnancy, that is the development of embryo and the structure, that is embryo. And after 8 weeks means from 9 weeks to 9 months, 10 days approx. So this time period, the structure, that is known as fetus, means the embryo. When within the embryo, the system means nervous system, excretory system, circulatory system, digestive system, it is fully formed, and therefore it looks like the human baby in human body. So that is the structure, that is fetus. So 0 to 8 weeks means 2 months, 0 to 2 months, this time period approximately, that is the structure will form, that is the embryo. And after embryo means after 8 weeks, means from 9 weeks, the structure which will ultimately develop, which will form, that is the structure known as fetus. So ultimately fetus quite developed than embryo. So now I will tell you about implantation. What do you mean by implantation? What will occur after implantation and the site of implantation? Implantation means, you know, in the female reproductive system, I have already told you, in the structure of female reproductive system, you know what will occur in the uterine wall. In the uterine wall, the morula means the cell mass without layer, after the formation of zygote, the morula, it will come and it will attach in the dorsal wall of the uterus. the attachment of the embryo in the dorsal wall of the uterus for the development of embryo, that is the known as implantation. So implantation means just the attachment of embryo in the dorsal wall of the uterus to take nutrition from its mother body and for development, that is implantation. So implantation occurs in uterine wall, not in fallopian tube. Fertilization occurs in fallopian tube, but the implantation occurs in uterine wall. That is the differences. And in implantation, after implantation there will be the development of embryo, means after implantation there will be formation of blastula or blastocyst and therefore gastrula, and in gastrula three main layers will form: ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. These are the structure of implantation. Now what about amniocentesis and what about placenta? Is there any kinds of function regarding it? Amniocentesis means after the formation of embryo within the sac, there will be a fluid. So the fluid helps to prevent the embryo from any foreign body, from any kinds of disease. Also the liquid which is present in the sac helps to prevent the embryo from any mechanical shock. The liquid, that is known as amniotic fluid. And amniocentesis means if we collect that fluid, very small amount, if we collect that fluid, with the help of that fluid we can easily determine, after test the doctor can determine that with the help of that amniotic fluid the would be baby, is there any chromosomal aberrance, chromosomal disorder, and also there will be also any kinds of without chromosomal disease there will be also any other genetical inheritance disease. So the would be baby, it will carry any kinds of disease or completely normal. So that helps to determine with the help of the process amniocentesis. But nowadays ultimately we don't do this process amniocentesis because there is some bad effects, means with the help of amniocentesis also we can determine the sex of the baby. So that's why, you know, if I determine, so either it will be male or female, you can easily determine it, therefore you know there will be some problem. So that is the reason amniocentesis is nowadays we don't do using, but that is the process, that is amniocentesis. And what is about placenta? Means after the formation of embryo, when it will form fetus, so in the fetus, when it will fetus, it will take nutrition from its mother body. Similarly, there will be respiratory system, there will be excretory system, means the waste product it will excrete it out. Also it will take nutrition from its mother body. So who will provide the nutrition to the fetus from its mother body? Who will provide oxygen or respiratory gases to the fetus? And similarly the waste product of the fetus, who will carry? The placenta helps to carry it. The placenta is the tissue, the structure which helps to give nutrition to the fetus from its mother body. Similarly oxygen, means respiratory gases, to it from its mother body. Similarly it helps to carry the waste product from the fetus, and it, after all, it will give nutrition and it will also give immunity to the fetus. So that is the function that is related to it, that is the function of placenta. So I told you that placenta is a tissue, it helps to do it. So that is the structure placenta. Now I will tell you about sex determination and one more thing, that is lactation and parturition. Parturition means, you know, the pregnancy period, means within the mother body the development of fetus or the development of embryo, it will take time, approximately 9 months, 10 days we say that. This time period is the parturition period. And lactation period means, you know, after the childbirth, from the mammary gland milk will ejaculate, so baby feet, just like we use it. So it is lots of nutrition for baby, for the growth and development. So that is the lactation period. For a particular time period the lactation will occur, means the milk ejaculation occurs from mother body. Now I will tell you about sex determination. Ultimately, you know, in male body we have XY means we have two sex chromosomes, one is X, other one is Y, and in female body two sex chromosomes are there, XX. So from male body X will come, so similarly from female body also another X will come, so the product is daughter. But if from male body Y will come and from female body you know only X will come, no options are there, then the product will form, that is son. So the sex determining factor depend on father, whether they are providing, they are providing X chromosome or Y chromosome, depend on them. So ultimately they don't know what will occur, what will come. So it will depend on the chromosomal aberration or the chromosomal changes. So if from father body X chromosome will come, so there will be daughter. And if from mother body if from father body Y chromosome will come, of course there will be son. So the sex determining factor, just I am also giving another example, if the father will give that X and the mother will give that X, so you know there will be also formation of XX means daughter. But if the father will give Y and the mother will give that X, so there will be also formation of son. So depend on father, the sex determining factor, whether X chromosome is coming or Y chromosome will come, depend on the sex determining factor, depend on father. So that is regarding the reproductive system. Thank you very much. We completed our unit, means reproduction. So next topic I will start maybe molecular biology or any other diseases.